of this month, Jose Sanchez del Rio was became canonized saint of the Catholic Church. Saint Jose lived through the great persecution in Mexico from 1924 to 1928. During that persecution by the Masonic government in Mexico, religious orders were banned. There was no church property, it was all confiscated. Priests and religious were denied a trial by jury and the right to vote. Catholics were fined and put in prison for teaching church doctrine. Clerical dress was forbidden. It was a time of great darkness for the church in Mexico. But there were brave Catholics in Mexico at that time who stood up, who held on to their faith, who knew that their faith in our Lord Jesus Christ was paramount. They were called Cristeros. Jose became a Cristero. He worked for the liberation of the church and the defense of the faith in his country. At age 14, Saint Jose was caught by the federal army. He was tortured to renounce his faith because they believed if this young man, this Cristero, only 14, could publicly renounce his faith, that would be a great blow to the Catholics. They tortured him. But Jose would not renounce his faith. He held fast. Finally, the day of his death, the final torture was they cut off the soles of his feet. Then they made him walk barefoot to his place of execution. Saint Jose, again, held fast. He was in prayer. He was peaceful and calm. And before he was killed, he yelled out in great acclamation with a beautiful smile on his face, "Viva Cristo Rey! Long live Christ the King!" And then he was executed. What an example we have, Saint Jose, of youth, of young people, of perseverance in the faith, even in the midst of great persecution. Dear friends, we need a saint like Saint Jose now more than we ever had. Because we are under persecution today as we never have been. Saint Jose, he's our patron for youth, for Catholic youth. He's our patron for all of us who feel persecuted. And yes, we're all persecuted. All persecution comes ultimately from Satan. The devil is the great persecutor who prowls round like a lion looking for someone to eat. What does Scripture tell us we have to do? Stand firm in faith, just like Saint Jose did in the midst of persecution. We can't escape persecution. Satan uses various instruments in the world to persecute us. He used that government in Mexico. Today, even in Australia, we can be persecuted for holding fast to church doctrines, can't we? Just get up and say too much about the traditional Christian view of marriage between a man and a woman, and you'll find out how we have to suffer persecution in our country. But there's also other ways subtle ways than we have to suffer persecution from the evil one. Scandal. The scandals that we hear about so often in the church. The sexual abuse scandal that keeps hitting us all the time. Perpetrated by a few, but persecutes us. We suffer persecution before of those sinners. And we can get people who are scandalised by what people in the church do. It could be a cranky old priest who snaps at an altar boy, and that altar boy never comes back to church. I've heard that so often. Scandal. That's a way that the evil one can use to take us away from Christ, to persecute our faith, because that's what persecution is all about. It's there to make us renounce Christ, drag us away from Christ, be too heavy for us to bear. So scandal, we've got to be careful about scandal. Apathy, form of diabolic persecution, apathy. We suffer that a lot in our country, don't we? When it comes to the important things in life, creation, your final end, what's our attitude? Give it right, mate. No worries. Apathy. Apathy, tiredness. Oh, I just can't do all those prayers anymore. It's just so hard doing the right thing. It's so hard keeping the commandments. We get tired and we lose heart. We fall into pessimism. We see evil around us and think, well, what's the use? That's a form of persecution. We often don't identify it as such. It's part of the spiritual warfare that's used against us. Dear friends, we need to wake up. We need to stand tall. We need to pledge ourselves to Christ the King. We are in a spiritual battle. That is plain to see for anyone who has eyes. We have the remedy. We have our weapons of that spiritual battle. Prayer and penance. We know that. Tried and true. You good people have just been on a pilgrimage. What a great devotion that combines those two elements. Prayer and penance. Our world, our Christian world, our Catholic world, seems suddenly to forget about penance as an important weapon in our spiritual battle. God bless you for going on a pilgrimage, for arming yourselves with those spiritual weapons, for getting in there and fighting the good fight. Cardinal Alberto Suarez Inda from Mexico wrote this just after St. Jose's canonization. He said, we need to react and be truly faithful to Jesus in virtue, in an attitude of trust in God, and also in facing all those obstacles presented to the Christian life in today's world, in whatever time or environment. Dear brothers and sisters, we need, like St. Jose, to pledge our lives to Christ our King, and be prepared to persevere, to ask each day for that grace and that strength to persevere in our faith, no matter what persecutions we face. Let our constant prayer be, Viva Christus.